It's kind of fun seeing things that are new.
I and seeing animals back from the zoo.
D. Lots of celebrity interviews. D.
And many super kids too.
I.
That's entertainment, the best to be found.
And
as much fun as a merry-go-round.
G.
We're gonna keep you spellbound. That spells kitten.
I'm Steve Smith.
And I'm Carrie Fischer. We have a very special show planned for today.
That's right. With the help of our super-duper, wonderfully fantastic Kidding Around time machine, we're going to take a look back at many of you who were with us during the season.
That's right. We'll see dancers, bands, cheerleaders, celebrities, and lots more.
Shall we fire it up?
Okay. How do you get it started?
Well, according to the manual, it's the switch on the end.
This end?
I guess this end right
okay,
here.
Okay. Is this it?
That's it. That's it.
Okay,
that's it.
Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Here goes.
Go for it.
So stay with us, we'll be right back with lots of fun and surprises today on Kidding Around.
We will return after these messages. Now back to Kidding Around.
Steve, you know, we have had so many wonderful and talented kids
season. It's been terrific. And I can't wait for old Time Machine to take us back and look at some of those folks.
I can't either.
But before we do anything else, I'm going to throw this switch here. You know what it's going to do?
What?
We're going to go back and look at our first show together.
We are?
Way back at the beginning of the season when we first met. Now then, who is this ravishing redhead, you may ask? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present our new co-host, Miss Carrie Fisher!
Oh, my goodness. So embarrassed.
Ravishing redhead, and you are ravishing, too.
Well, now let's get to some more talented kids, you know.
Okay.
Well, I'm talking about, like, first of all, our dancers. We've had so many different kinds. We've had disco and tap and 50s and even Irish dancers.
A hoofer's heaven.
That's right. Now I'd like to take a look at some of them.
That switch?
This one.
I can't wait.
Neither can
Maybe
I.
I'll remember some of the steps.
I do know that I love you.
Oh, that was our
Oh, Gene Kelly, eat your heart out.
No.
You know, one thing that we've had is an incredible variety of things on the show. We've had karate demonstrations, singers, magicians, puppeteers. Why don't we take a look at some of those now? Have you got the right switch there?
Yeah, here it is. Right, right here.
Right there?
Yep.
All right.
There we go.
You know, I think we're really getting the hang of this machine.
We are.
Let this be a Merry Christmas with love and goodness to last the new year through.
Yeah.
That Heather was cute.
Wasn't yeah, she?
Yeah,
sure
I
was.
Thought so too. Well, one thing that we've had an abundance of this year is your celebrity corner. You have talked
about all kinds of people. I have. Why don't we look back at some of that now?
Good idea.
Okay, this is the switch.
You really know your stuff with this thing, don't you?
I've been reading up.
Ah.
Remember all those eligible celebrities that got married? First was the handsome actor Erik Estrada, who plays Punch on the TV series Chips. Erik married Joyce Miller, who has a 14-year-old son. The couple slipped away last November for a quiet wedding ceremony in Las Vegas. Next came the wedding of actor-singer Shaun Cassidy to fashion model Ann Pennington. The couple had a beautiful outdoor wedding ceremony right next to Shaun's house. Actor-musician Willie Aames also got tired of bachelor living. Willie married his high school sweetheart Vicki Averback, and the couple moved to a new house in Beverly Hills. Actress Connie Newton, who was one of Ada's and Alf's kids, married her steady boyfriend, David Needham. The couple had a really large wedding. We also took a look at who was dating who. Actor Robby Benson and longtime girlfriend, actress Marilu Magnuson, were still seeing each other, but they didn't tie the knot this year. John Travolta and Marilu Henner denied all rumors that they were serious about each other. Both John and Marilu claimed that they are just good friends. Actress Farrah Fawcett and her husband, actor Lee Majors, split. And Farrah started seeing actor Ryan O'Neill this year. Moving outside of the dating scene, we had some sad news, too. Actor Erik Estrada spent most of last August flat on his back from a motorcycle accident he had while filming Chips. Luckily, Erik had a quick recovery and is as healthy as ever. John Travolta had an accident, too, but it wasn't quite as serious as Erik's. John's Labrador Retriever bit him on the nose, and John was in a lot of pain for a while, but he recovered quickly. Moving into the TV scene, Charlie's Angels had a lot of ups and downs this year. Jaclyn Smith, the only original cast member left on the series, felt like she wanted to move on. And so did one of her co-stars, Cheryl Ladd. Cheryl became interested in devoting more of her time to a new singing career. Well, as it turns out, Cheryl and Jaclyn never left the series. But the newest angel, Shelley Hack, was asked to leave the show. Word has it that Shelley will still make some guest appearances on Charlie's Angels next season. Victor Willis, the ex-lead singer of the Village People, left the group this year because he wasn't getting along with the other members. John Schneider, who plays the part of Beau Duke on the Dukes of Hazzard, was an unknown actor at the beginning of this year's season, but John has since become one of the most popular TV stars around. The talented and pretty Randi Oakes ran the Chips series. Before Chips, Randi had been in a lot of commercials. Dina Schofield, who plays Fred the Radar in Archie Bunker's place, became a popular TV star too, and so did the co-host of King Around, Steve Smith. Of course, he had some help in reaching stardom.
Well, that's going a little quicker than I thought.
Yeah.
I think maybe I just dialed something a little too wrong there. Phew! Well, not only did we talk about celebrities, we were lucky enough to meet some of them.
Yeah, we were.
I think that's the next venture we ought to take.
Okay.
This is the switch, and
yep.
I assume that this time I won't be racing through it like I did the last time. Ah, yes.
Hello.
Hi.
What's it like growing up in a showbiz family?
Well, I don't know any different. That's all I know. For me, it was very exciting. It was, it meant a lot of traveling. It meant meeting a lot of people that maybe I wouldn't have had the chance to meet had I grown up in a family that was involved in another profession.
Do you like being on the road?
I love it.
You really do?
Yeah, it's fun.
What's the thing that you like most about it?
Well, I don't know, going to all the different cities and everything, it's just really a lot of fun. We see lots of things, and we get invited lots of places, and we have lots of fun.
I'll bet you do. What's the one thing you miss most?
Well, I miss my friends and my cat, but...
You have a cat back home?
Yeah, Peppy.
What's in the future for the Jacksons?
More hit albums.
More writing, more hit albums.
More producing.
Is that what gives you the most pleasure, being able to write and produce all your own?
Yeah. Not only that, it's being able to write and produce your own stuff and the public out there accepting it.
There you go.
And that's what we love. We appreciate that they're accepting our music the way they have been.
How did your parents feel when you told them you wanted to get in the show business?
Well, you know, it was kind of a brash thing to walk up to them. At 17 is when I hit the road. And I said, I'm going to make it. And show business. Up to that point, I always said, well, I guess I'll be a dentist. That's what I was going
to
do.
Why don't we find out how you all got together and decided to become a band?
Okay, I started this. Three of us were playing in a band here in Chicago about 3.5-4 years ago, and we had an angel who said, if you guys will go out and find three wonderful women to sing for you, that he would support us and get us rolling as a band. And that's how pretty much how it started.
Ah, there's no business like show business.
Yes.
Doesn't Rex Smith have a nice last name?
Yeah.
I think he's got a great last name.
Oh, goodness.
Boy, this thing is getting hot, you know that? Holy
cow.
Ooh,
it is.
I better check the manual. What's up next?
Well, another big part of our show has been animals. We've had them from the Lincoln Park Zoo and the Anti-Cruelty Society. And let's go back and take a look at some of those.
Good idea.
Okay.
Oh, animals,
I love animals. I do.
That chameleon just kills me, you know? Say,
up.
do you smell something funny?
No, I've got a cold.
Hey, Wiz, I'm beginning to wonder about our handy-dandy machine here.
Well, anyway, you know how you remember me in our very first show together?
Oh, yeah.
Well, right now I'd like to show you how I'm always going to remember you, okay?
This is how you're always going to remember me?
Yep, I'm always going
to
remember you.
Oh, I can't wait to get a load of this.
Here we go.
Uh-huh. I would now like to give my impression of chameleon eating cricket.
I thought that was good.
Okay, Fischer, you're going to get yours, you know. You're really going to get yours. Well,
thanks.
We still have lots more to see with the help of our handy-dandy time machine.
So stay with us for lots more King Round, hopefully.
Kidding Around will return after these messages. Now back to Kidding Around.
Ah, there, that ought to do it. The machine is fixed. That's it. It's all fixed. Right back in order.
Yeah, this is why you fix it.
Moving right along. You know, during the past season on Kidding Around, we have listened to lots of good music together. Everything from country and western with Charlie Daniels to computer music, which you ought to enjoy. But I think until our machine doesn't fracture a fuse, we ought to take a look and listen back to just some of our faves, shall we?
Okay.
Ah, the music world.
Down to Georgia.
I'm all shook up.
Ah, lots of good music,
yeah,
you know?
Sure has.
What's next? Wait, let's check the old info feed here.
Okay.
Let me see. No, we did that. No, animals, we did that. Oh, there it is right there. Put computer card into machine. Where'd you put the computer card into the machine? That is for the...
There we go.
Ah, that's it.
All right. Bands,
you got
it. Yeah, we sure have had a lot of them, and you know, if any of them ever become really famous, we can say they started here.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log.
The world go around.
Sure does.
Well, another thing that we've had a lot of are our cheerleaders and pom-pom squads, drill teams. Why, what I think we'll do now is take a peek at them.
Okay, they all have neat outfits,
Let's
too.
Let's rah-rah right into it. Away we go. Scoomba!
Woo!
I think I'd like to be a cheerleader, except I don't think I have the legs for it.
Oh. Goodness.
Well, next are riddles and jokes. Oh, probably my favorite part of the whole show.
It has. It's been such a, it's a big part, too.
When we get to share with
share,
our audience.
Right.
You want to flip the switch?
Okay.
Here we go.
There we go.
Why does a baby act like a car?
Why does a baby act like a car?
Because they both have a rattle.
What is yellow, has a bionic ear, and fights crime?
What?
The $6 million corn.
Why do golfers wear two pairs of pants?
Why do golfers wear two pairs of pants?
In case they get a hole in one.
Why didn't the skeleton cross the road?
Why didn't the skeleton cross the road?
Because he didn't have the guts.
There is a room that has no floor, it has no windows, and no door. What is it?
What is it?
A mushroom.
What do you call a witch doctor's mistake?
What do you call a witch doctor's mistake?
A voodoo boo-boo. I like that one now. Come on here.
What do you get when you cross a cocker spaniel, a poodle, and a rooster?
How about a cocker poodle doo?
If bananas come under fruit and carrots come under vegetables, what does an egg come under?
I give up. What does an egg come under?
A chicken.
Of course.
How do you know the ocean is friendly?
How do you know the ocean is friendly?
It waves.
What has red hair, laughs funny, and is weird?
What?
Carrie Fisher.
Graham, small fry.
What is a 10-letter word that starts with G-A-S?
G...
10-letter word.
Yeah.
Automobile.
Mr. Green is a butcher. He's 6 feet tall, wears size 10 shoes. What does he weigh?
I give up. What does he weigh?
Meat. Which is faster, heat or cold?
Which is faster, heat or cold?
Heat. You can catch a cold.
What do you call it when giraffes moving one way get mixed up with giraffes going the other way?
What do you call it when giraffes moving one way get mixed up with giraffes moving the other way?
That's what I said. Well, the answer is a giraffic jam.
What do you do when a nose goes on strike?
What do you do when a nose goes on strike?
You pick it.
What do you call a weird stove?
What do you call a weird stove?
A strange range. What do you call an ice cream cone lost on a prairie?
What do you call an ice cream cone lost on a prairie?
A lone cone.
What time is it when you go to the dentist? Give up? 2:30.
Those were funny.
We have some great writers out there, don't we?
We sure did. We just got tons of them.
Well, hasn't been a gas looking back over the past season?
It has.
It's been grand. Well, this is our last regular Kidding Around program for the season, but I really want to thank all of you for being with us. I want to thank you, and I especially want to thank you. Well, it looks like we sort of turned things inside out. I'm not quite sure.
What are we going to do now?
Well, I don't worry about a thing. I'll fix everything.
Yeah. Well, that could take forever. Well, while Steve and I are gone trying to fix this time machine and trying to get ourselves out of here, you can watch our reruns Saturdays at noon and Sunday mornings at 7:30.
Yeah, well, have a great summer. We'll see you next fall, I hope. Oh. Would you hold the manual?
Yeah, all right. I'll give you directions, all right?